Hi folks, John from Designed Elegance Pastry Shop here for you. So for tonight's lesson, we are going to melt some chocolate and we are going to dip some strawberries into that chocolate. We're going to make a very nice refreshing snack that anyone can try anytime. It's a very simple dessert, but it's always a hit. So I've got a bag of chocolate, 12 ounce bag. Your favorite chocolate will do from the grocery store, whatever. I've got it in a glass bowl. So I'm going to take it to the microwave and I am going to melt it for 30 seconds. And then I'm going to let it rest for about a minute or so. And then I'm going to give it another 30 seconds. And then I'm going to stir it. Once I stir it, I will feel how much more time in the microwave it's going to need. So again, when you're melting chocolate in a microwave, you want to do it slow and gentle, a little bit at a time, and give it a little rest in between. So I'll be right back with the chocolate. Okay, now I'm going to come to the table here. So it's already been in for 30 seconds and then 30 seconds. Notice this little area here where it looks a little dark. See, that's really melting right there. Also, this is warm to the touch on the bottom. This feels like a bowl of soup that's not quite hot enough yet. So now I'm going to stir and notice what the chocolate that was touching the bowl against the surface of the bowl, that's what's melting first. Okay, so I'm bringing that into the center and I'm just basically coating the more solid pieces with the more loose chocolate that's already been melted. Nice and gentle, nice and slow. We're not in a hurry. We don't want to burn the chocolate. Okay, so we've got it pretty well stirred around. Okay, let's give it another 30 seconds. This is probably going to be enough right here. By the time I get done stirring it in smooth, there'll probably be plenty of heat in the bowl already for it to melt smooth, to finish melting it off.
Oh, folks, if you get a chance, please like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. It really helps us out.
All righty. Yeah, I can tell just by the feel of this bowl that that's probably going to be enough. Notice how the surface is all wet now. Oh yeah. There you go. That's my son, Tim. Okay, so now I'm just going to melt the rest of it smooth. The last few pieces. There we go. Last few pieces are smoothing right out. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Okay. Now what we're trying to avoid is overcooking it, overheating it. What that does is it'll, like a laser, it'll burn a little spot and it'll turn to basically charcoal. And you get that burnt charred taste. It's not very good. So you want to be careful to avoid that. Okay, so now I have my chocolate all ready to go. I'm gonna put it right there on the side by my pan. I need to grab my strawberries here. All right, folks, so you always wanna dip cold strawberries that are right out of the fridge. Now, these strawberries, in preparation for this lesson, what I did was earlier today, I rinsed these strawberries, and then I let them air dry, and then I put them on a different pan so that they wouldn't be wet, but they are clean. And the reason for that is that water and chocolate do not mix. Again, water and chocolate do not mix. So always keep that in mind. Okay, so what we want to do is there's a couple of different methods that we can do. My favorite method is to just go for it right off the bat. You grab the hull very carefully, and what you want to do is dip the top in, lift it up, let it drip for a sec. Okay, you can swipe the bottom so that the tail is off, and then you just set it on the pan. Okay, let's do that again. Okay, I'm gonna take the prettiest side, okay, right here, put that up. Okay, see how I just dipped the top, the whole surface, let it drip a second, pull that little tail off, and then I'm gonna set it down. Notice I'm pushing it forward just a little bit to hide the tail in the front. Grab a few papers here. And these are just little cupcake liners from the grocery store, okay? Grab the strawberry, pop it in, and just set it right on like so. Okay, now it's already in a paper, easy to serve. You don't have to worry about putting tongs on your tray, so to speak. There you go. Uh-huh. And we'll hit that one there. Set it right in. Okay, now, let's do this. Okay, got some chopped walnuts here, okay? We'll take our little strawberry, okay? Drop it in the chocolate, put it in some nuts, and then put it in our paper. Oh, look at that.
That looks pretty.
Oh yeah, that looks good, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
There you go. Okay, so now we'll do another one of those. Now notice that we can actually, okay, by going through your cupboard and seeing what you folks have in the pantry, you can actually plan your little desserts with just a little bit of chocolate, a little bit of fruit. Okay. This is always a hit. Better than a candy bar, I would think. Okay, so there's that. Now let's do a little coconut here. Okay. That's always good. Okay, now I don't want to dip my chocolate into the coconut. Okay, so I'm just going to take and put a little bit on the table here like so. Okay, so we dip in the chocolate. Now hit the coconut. Now I'm only doing half of the front. Did you notice that? Mm-hmm. You want to do half of the front. See, so you got some chocolate showing, and then you got the coconut on the side. The same with the nuts. You got a big blotch of chocolate on the one side, and then the other side's pretty much covered with the nuts. Right. So that gives people, you know, you give a little contrast. People see what's underneath. They know what to expect. Okay.
You could probably use orange zest if you wanted, right?
You mean for a flavor enhancer?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That would be very flavorful. Very flavorful indeed. Okay, so now, also, we can, you know, just basically do some sprinkles. Okay. Now, if you're doing sprinkles, I highly recommend that you do them right on. Oop. Okay. This is good that this happened. I just lost my hull. Okay. So, we have a toothpick. And we have a little plastic fork. I'm going to use my toothpick to stab it and to get it out, okay? And now I'm going to use my fork to pull it away, okay? And now I'm going to take the little bit of the hull here, take a little bit of chocolate, and stick that little guy back on there just to make it look like all the rest. Now, while it's this, before the chocolate sets, I'm going to tap a few sprinkles on. Okay, look at that. Isn't that nice?
That's so pretty.
Yeah. So like for a baby shower or, you know, some kind of, you know, maybe a child's birthday where the child has, you know, a favorite color and they want to, you know, you want to serve, say a little girl's having a party and you do pink sprinkled chocolate dipped strawberries. Wouldn't that just be lovely? See, here's some gold sugar on the chocolate. That's got a nice contrast, so that's why I like doing those. There.
And again, if you have any questions for John, please throw them in the comments. Let us know you like our videos. And if there's any particular topics you want John to cover, throw it in the comments.
Yeah, that would be great. I would love some ideas. I would say, would you like to try one here?
I would.
Which one do you want to try? You want to try one with nuts or with coconut? Maybe with a plain one?
Give me just a sec.
You just decide what you want. I've tried them all.
All right. Okay.
Okay.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
You.
That's fruit.
I'm going to try this guy.
All right. Yeah, if it was in the cooler, then it would, you know, that would have set up already. See, I'm going to go for this one. It'll be a little less messy. Okay.
That's good messy. That's good messy.
You like that?
Oh, yeah.
All right, so.
By far my favorite dessert.
You like these? Mm-hmm. Again, folks, these are fabulous for whenever you want to have a few people over. If you ever want to have a refreshing snack, sweet.
Or guys, if you want to surprise your woman.
Oh, yeah, these are wonderful. So, I hope you folks have enjoyed this video, and just remember, whenever you bake with joy and with love, it's sure to be delicious. So, happy baking. Thank you.